Sí, ya digo que le.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to express my views on the supplementary demands for grants.
Three minutes, sir. I'll do my best, sir.
For excess grants placed before the Honorable Finance Minister. Sir, the COVID-19 pandemic is a shock that not only shattered our economy, but also affected consumer sentiment in unprecedented manner. The negative 24% GDP growth year on year of the first quarter of this fiscal indicates the recession that India has to pass through this year and in subsequent years if the corrective interventions are not made. This indicates that rupees 8.5 billion of national income, or about $115 billion at the current exchange rate, has gone up in smoke, sir. There is no doubt that it is due to unprecedented suspension of economic activity. But even after this lockdown, the situation is not so bright either, sir. So we have to focus on this. Sir, there are indications coming from the RBI that there would be a second stimulus. I wish that this stimulus would be focused on entirely on how to make money available to individual citizens of this country so that they will spend the money, create demand, and the wheel of the economy starts rolling. Sir, we are all facing the same storm, but we are all not in the same boat, sir. Some businesses have suffered much more, such as travel, tourism, construction, MSMEs across verticals, and while others have prospered, such as technology, telecom, pharma, healthcare, and e-commerce. For the middle class and the rich, the pandemic has been an inconvenience, but for the poor, including the migrant labor and the daily wage workers, it's become a matter of life and death, sir. The financial support and the stimulus package needs to be directed to support the most vulnerable people and the most vulnerable businesses, sir. I wish and hope that the second stimulus will come very soon. Sir, I request the Honorable Finance Minister to release the pending GST dues to the tune of 3,600 crores to Andhra Pradesh and also the Finance Commission grants immediately, sir. I also request the Honorable FM to release the pending bills of 3,200 crores towards Polavaram. I'm requesting because the financial position of AP is on the verge of collapse with nearly 5% fiscal deficit, revenue deficit shooting up to 2.5%. Just 1 minute, sir, I'll finish.
Please.
In 2.5% in 1920 against the target of 0.16%. Borrowings already pegged for this financial year at 60,250 crores, and there's a 20% increase in the fiscal deficit. Sir, I'm giving these statistics from the budget papers of Andhra Pradesh, which indicates the pathetic financial position, and that is the reason why I'm requesting you to help my state. Sir, 29 commitments made in the AP Reorganization Act, none of them have been fully implemented, and no funds have been allotted to this, including for SCS, sir. Sir, the YSRCP, instead of focusing on vindictive politics, they should be, their priorities have become very clear. They're not talking about COVID, they're not talking about the economy, they're trying to cover up their failures and diverting the attention and misleading the House, sir. And MP-led funds, when we look at, classifying the expenditure into critical, essential and desirable, MP-led funds certainly fall under critical, sir, and they should not be touched and we should not be denied that ability, sir. Sir, last point, sir. Sir, the AP government hasn't been in power for 16 months. They've taken a vindictive approach right from the beginning. 16 months of investigation, they've been unable to do anything. They're now insisting that cases should be handing over to the CBI to ensure a fair and unbiased investigation with credibility. Isn't it an admission of their own failure and their own inability to provide a fair and unbiased investigation with credibility, sir? Sir, more than 80 cases in the High Court and Supreme Court have gone against the YSRCP government. Instead of being ashamed of this record, they have the audacity to cast aspersions on the courts and the judges of this country, sir.
Okay.
They are proving again that they have no respect for rule of law, nor the judiciary, sir. What about the CBI cases pending against the present CM of AP for more than 10 years, sir? With these observations, I support the demand of grants. Thank you, sir.
Sir, what is it?
Thank you, sir.
Sir, thank you very much for...